When the English colonists sailed for the New World, they brought only their most precious and essential possessions with them, including the works of William Shakespeare. The earliest known staging of his plays in the colonies was in 1750. By the time of the American Revolution, Shakespeare's plays had been performed hundreds of times in thriving New England port cities and new towns and villages hewn from the wilderness. The young nation, brought together under a unique constitution and collective will, found common ground in the love of Shakespeare. In his famous travelogue, Democracy and America, the French writer Alexis de Tocqueville remarked on the popularity of Shakespeare across the new nation in the 1830s. "There is hardly a pioneer's hut," de Tocqueville observed with astonishment, "that does not contain a few odd volumes of Shakespeare. I remember that I read the feudal drama of Henry V for the first time in a log cabin." One such log cabin belonged to the family of Abraham Lincoln, a frontiersman whose formative reading consisted mainly of the King James Bible, Blackstone's lectures on English law, and Shakespeare. Like so many American presidents, Lincoln had a lifelong fondness for the bard. As the German journalist Karl Knorz wrote in the 1880s, "There is assuredly no other country on earth in which Shakespeare and the Bible are held in such general high esteem." Throughout the 19th century, Shakespeare was the most popular playwright in America. His plays were produced in large, opulent theaters and on makeshift stages in saloons, churches, and hotels. From big cities on the East Coast to mining camps in the frontier West, his plays were performed prominently and frequently. In fact, Shakespearean actors sailed from England to America because the job prospects with touring theatrical troupes were plentiful and exciting. He was a poet whose most famous speeches most Americans knew by heart. Shakespeare was so integrated into American culture by the 19th century that Mark Twain had his young hero, Huckleberry Finn, travel along the Mississippi River by raft with a pair of rogues who tried to pass themselves off as Shakespearean actors to earn money in riverbank towns. Productions of Shakespeare attracted broad audiences from every class, culture, and ethnic group. Audiences articulated their knowledge of the plays and their opinion of the performers by hissing, whistling, stamping, clapping, and reciting passages along with the actors. During breaks between acts, the plays were often accompanied by music, acrobatics, dance, magic shows, minstrel shows, and stand-up comedy. Shakespeare's most famous lines and scenes, such as Hamlet's "To be or not to be" speech, were parodied through short skits and satirical songs inserted into other modes of entertainment, demonstrating how well performers and audiences alike knew his work. Only in the 20th century did the nature of Shakespeare's relationship to the American public slowly begin to change. He was still the most widely known, respected, and quoted dramatist, but his work gradually came to be seen as part of high culture rather than popular culture. His plays became more known as educational texts than entertainments, more as the possession of an elite coterie than the property of all Americans. The once universally accessible dramatist, whom audiences adored even when they parodied him, now became the sacred dramatist to whom everyday people could hardly relate. In the meantime, the American language moved away from the rich Elizabethan style of Shakespeare, making his words sound slightly foreign to a people who once so effortlessly understood their power. Still, for more than four centuries, Shakespeare has played a defining role in American culture. Today, he remains the most widely produced playwright in America, performed in theaters, on film, in schools, at festivals, and read in millions of homes across the nation. The nature of Shakespeare's special relationship to the American people will continue to change and develop, but the relationship itself will undoubtedly remain strong and singular. Although born in England, William Shakespeare has become a permanent part of the American imagination.